या वंस अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर दिस स्ट्रक्चर एनालिसिस कोर्स. इन दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग एनालिसिस ऑफ फ्रेम्स, एनालिसिस ऑफ स्वे फ्रेम बाय यूजिंग मोमेंट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मेथड. वी आर सीइंग हियर. ओके, सो वंस अगेन वी विल सी द प्रोसीजर. But the analysis of frame by using analysis of sway frame by using moment distribution method, we'll use this procedure. First, we'll analyze the frame. We're going to analyze the frame by providing a support at beam level, and we'll assume this frame as a non-sway frame. Like that, we're going to calculate non-sway analysis. That means non-sway moments we're going to calculate in first step. First, we're going to calculate non-sway moments. How are we going to calculate non-sway moments? If you let us suppose, so this is a frame, this is a portal frame. The supports are in different level. Support A and support D are in different level. Because of the supports are some geometry, if you see this geometry of this frame, this is not symmetrical. So the sway is possible because of the supports. If you see the loading, because of the loading also the sway is possible. So if you see this figure, we can easily identify this is a sway frame. Okay, so how to analyze this frame? In first step, what we're going to do is the load is acting in this direction, that means horizontal direction, from, let us suppose, from left to right. So sway is possible. So to analyze this problem is a complex problem. To analyze this one, what we're going to do is we will arrest this sway first. We're going to arrest the sway by providing a support at the beam level. Okay, here we are providing support. So if you apply the load P here at this point or anywhere, the total load is taken by this support. The support will not move. So that means sway is arrested. Sway is arrested at a beam level. Okay, so because of this application of force, a reaction will develop at this beam level. Let us suppose the reaction is yes. The reaction is yes. So in first step, what we need to do is we have to calculate non-sway moments. Non-sway moments we need to calculate. How to calculate non-sway moments? So first we have to take fixed end moments. After that, we have to calculate distribution factors. After that, we'll going to solve by using moment distribution method. Moment distribution from the moment distribution table, we're going to calculate non-sway moments. Okay. So after that, for the analysis of sway frame, we require how much sway it takes place. That means how much deflection it is there. How much deflection it will be there, that we need to calculate first. Okay, that means deflection we require for the calculation of fixed end moment, 6 EI delta by L square. So we require the deflection, amount of deflection. So deflection is, calculation is not possible here, because here delta is not there. So that means moment calculation is not possible because delta is not there. Delta is, we need to calculate delta and we need to calculate moment. So to avoid this one, what we're going to do is we'll calculate moment ratios, moment of resistance of member AB to the moment of resistance to member CD, so that 6 EI delta by L square and 6 EI by delta by L square. Here the term delta will that means ratio between these moment ratios will from that we'll get. Okay, so first we are calculated non-sway moments. Okay, after that we have calculated a support reaction. After that we have applied the arbitrary moment at here, arbitrary moment for this beam. So same ratio, that means moment ratio is there here, mf1 by mf2 ratio will be there. We are going to calculate mf1 by mf2 with the same proportion. If you apply an arbitrary moment, an imaginary moment here, arbitrary moment here, the same proportion, the moment will develop here. Moment going to develop here. So by taking those moments, we're going to analyze this frame by using moment distribution method. So we'll see one by one. So for the calculation of total moment or sway moment, final moments is equal to non-sway moments. From this, we're going to get non-sway moments plus K into sway moments. K is a sway correction factor. K is a sway correction factor. So here we'll discuss in detail about the problem while solving this problem. Okay. So now listen carefully. This problem is some complicated problem. We'll try to solve this problem. Analyze the frame by movement distribution method. So this is the problem. Figure is given here. You see this figure. One support is fixed support. Another first support is a hinged support. Here two B and C are the rigid joints. Two joints is there. The supports is there. A and D is the supports, and B and C is the joints. Okay. For the member BC, a uniform distributed load is acting, that is 30 kN. To analyze this beam, what is my analysis? We need to find out the final end moments. Final moments, we need to calculate reactions, we need to calculate horizontal reactions and vertical reactions, we need to calculate. After that, we're going to draw bending moment diagram and we need to draw shear force diagram. Okay. To analyze this beam, so first we need to identify which type of, we analyze this frame. First, we need to identify which type of frame it is, whether it is sway frame or non-sway frame. So if you see support configuration, support geometry, if you see, they are in a different level. By seeing this one, we can simply say that it is a sway frame. If you see the loading, so loading is symmetrical about y-axis. So this is a, because of the load, it is a, the frame is not a sway frame, but because of the geometry of geometry, so this is a sway frame. Because of the geometry, this is a sway frame. That means it will move. If you apply load, it will automatically move because of the support configuration and geometry. Here, the moment of inertia for this member is 2i and moment of inertia for this member is i. Okay. So this finally we can conclude that this is a sway frame. So for the analysis of sway frame, what we need to do is first step, we have to provide a support at beam level. We are providing support at beam level. So I'm providing roller support. Because of the provision of roller support, a support reaction will develop at this same support level. That is, yes, is developing here. Okay. So first, what we need to do, so because of the provision of the support, the frame will not sway. That means non-sway, this frame is called non-sway frame. The non-sway frame convert in and this frame is a non-sway frame. Okay. Now we need to analyze by using moment distribution method. So first I want to analyze this frame by using moment distribution method. In moment distribution method, first step, we need to calculate non-sway fixed end moments. Fixed end moments we need to calculate. Okay. Here, for the member BC, for the horizontal member BC, loading is applying. Load is taken by only, load is applying on the only BC member. For the AB member and the CD member, load is not acting. That means load is zero. Only self weight is acting for the members, AB and CD. For the BC member, a uniform distributed load of 30 kN is acting. So that means fixed end moments for the AB member and the CD member is zero. Fixed end member for AB member and the CD member is zero. Fixed end member for the BC member is going to calculate. That means MFBC we need to calculate, MFCB we need to calculate. Okay. MFAB, MFBA, MFCD, MFDC is equal to zero. Why? Because for the members AB and CD, loading is zero. Loading is not there. If loading is there, we need to calculate MFAB and MFBA, MFCD and MFDC. For these two vertical members, loading is not there. So that's why here the fixed moments is zero. Okay. So for the member BC, fixed moments is there, MFBC and MFCB, we need to calculate. MFBC is equal to WL square by 12 minus WL square by 12. MFCB is equal to plus WL square by 12. Okay? So MFBC is equal to minus WL square by 12. MFCB is equal to plus WL square by 12. So W value 30. L is the length of beam. That is BC member is 6 meters here. So if you calculate fixed moment for the AB member, fixed moment for the BC member, that is MFBC is equal to minus 90 kilometer meter. MFCB is equal to plus 90 kilometer meter. Okay. So like that, we're going to calculate. If
R-center load is also there. For AB member, R-center load, point load is there. It is acting at the center. Then how to calculate frictional moment? Simply, WL by 8. MFAB is equal to WL by 8. MFBA is equal to WL by 8. Like that. So depending upon the type of loading, we're going to calculate frictional moment for the different members. As same as beams. Beams, like in the first step, we need to calculate the frictional moments. Okay? So we are calculating frictional moments. After that, we are calculating distribution factors. So once again, I will not explain this once again, because we are seeing from a moment distribution method. Prati problem lo manam distribution factors chesinamandi. So we are calculating distribution factors by calculating rotation stiffness k value, 4ai by l and 3ai by l formula is chesukoni. So its far end is fixed, 4ai by l. Its far end is hinged, 3ai by l. So like that, we're going to calculate distribution factors. Distribution factors is equal to k by sigma k, where sigma k is the joint stiffness. So like that, we're going to calculate distribution factors for these two different members. So after that, we have to write, we have two supports is there, A and D. D is a hinged support. If you see clear, observe clearly, D is a hinged support. This is not a fixed support. So that means it will not take any moment. Support D will not take any moment. Anyhow, fixed moment for the DC member, CD member is zero. Okay. So first we need to write distribution factor for the joint B and joint C. I'm written. Joint B 0.5, 0.5. Joint C 0.571, 0.429. For the CB member, 0.429. For the CD member, 0.429. Distribution factor for the CB member, 0.571. Distribution factor for the BC member, 0.5. Distribution factor for the BA member, 0.5. After that, we need to write fixed moments. Fixed moment for the MFBC minus 90 kilometer meter. Fixed moment for the CB plus 90 kilometer meter. Okay. So I'm written fixed moments. After that, what we need to do? We have to calculate unbalanced moment. Unbalanced moment we need to calculate. At joint C, unbalanced moment of plus 90 is there. At joint B, unbalanced moment minus 90 is there. So we need to distribute this unbalanced moment by multiplying distribution factor. Minus 90 multiplied by 0.5, 45 will get. So plus, if you we are getting minus sign, we have to change the sign and add here. Okay, minus 45, here we need to write plus 45. So minus 90, 0.5 and minus 45, you have to write plus 45 here. Okay, after that, half of the moment we need to carry to near joint. Half of the moment we need to carry to the near joint. Here, 45 moment is there. We need to carry to the near joint as a carryover moment. Okay. So half of the 45 is 22.5. With the same sign, we need to carry. Okay. Similarly, if you take joint C,
here plus 90 kilometer meter is there, the unbalanced moment. So we need to multiply plus 90 into 0.571. We will get 51.39. So with a different sign, here plus value is there, we have to add by using the opposite sign, the minus sign. Then we could add yes. Now, so 90 multiplied by 0.429, we'll get 38.61. So we have to add the different sign, minus sign. Then add yes. Now, so here, if you see this support C, half of the moment we need to carry to the near joint or support. But here, joint D is a hinged joint. It will not take any moment. That's why I'm not transferring here. For joint B and joint A are the rigid joints. So that's why I'm carrying this moment, half of the moment here, carrying to near joint. Okay. So 51.39, then half of the moment I'm carrying to near joint B. Okay. Here minus 25.70. So like that, if you solve this problem by balancing and carry over, we have to take carry over moment and balancing moment. We have to calculate unbalanced moment. After that, you have to calculate balance transfer moment. After that, carry over moment we need to calculate. After calculation of all this value, if you sum this one, we will get the final moment. So these are the non-sway moments. So non-sway moments we are getting here. So for member A, we are getting non-sway moment 31.00. For joint B, 62.22. Joint C 51.91. Like that, we are getting non-sway moments. For the first figure, we are calculated
for the first figure, because we are provided support here, because of this provision of support, this sway frame becomes a non-sway frame. Sway frame becomes a non-sway frame. For this non-sway frame, we are calculated movements, final end movements we are calculated. Those final end movements are for NDA, non-sway moment is 31.00, for B, 62.22, for the C, 51.91. So like that, we are got the non-sway moments. Non-sway moments we got. Okay, after that, we need to calculate the reactions for the non-sway frame. We need to calculate reactions for the non-sway frame. Okay, for the calculation of reactions for the non-sway frame, so I'm using this processor. I'm taking moment about, we need to draw free body diagram. If you take free body diagram of member AB, here one moment is there, that is MAB. Here this moment is, one moment is there, here. One second. Yeah, if you see this joint moments, at joint A, we are getting positive value. At joint A, we are getting, that means MAB is equal to positive. That means moment at A is producing clockwise rotation. Okay, moment at A is clockwise. If you take at joint B, MBA is positive, MBC is negative. So this is clockwise moment. MBA is clockwise moment. MBC is anti-clockwise moment. MBC is anti-clockwise moment. If you take MCB, MCB is positive. MCB is positive. So this is C and this is B. MCB is positive. Here the moment is positive. MCD is negative. Okay. MCD is negative. Anti-clockwise moment. Okay, so for that, for the calculation of reactions, okay, for the calculation of reactions, HA and HD, here HD will be there. So we need to calculate, what are the reactions we need to calculate? We need to calculate HA. And we need to calculate HD so that we can able to calculate the reaction, sway reaction, S. S value will going to calculate. For the calculation of S, we require, for the calculation of S, we have only option is there, that is sigma fx is equal to 0. If you do sigma fx is equal to 0, you're going to get S value. Okay. So simplest way is sigma fx is equal to 0. Only option, Galandi. So simplest way is sigma fx is equal to 0. For that, we need to calculate HA value and HD value. So if you know HA value and HD value, if you do sigma fx is equal to 0, you will going to get S value. Okay. So this is a sway force. Sway reaction force we will going to calculate from this. For that, what we need to do, we have to calculate HA value by taking moment about B. So otherwise, you remember this formula. MAB plus MBA by L. MAB plus MBA by L, that is the formula for the calculation of reaction at support horizontal reaction for the calculation. MAB plus MBA, MAB plus MBA by 6 L, MAB plus MBA by L is the formula with the same sign, whether it is clockwise or anti-clockwise. Same sign, to clockwise and clockwise sign, anti-clockwise and anti-clockwise sign. To HA is equal to MAB is equal to 31 plus 31, that is clockwise moment. MBA is also clockwise moment, that is 62.22. L value is 6. If you do this one, HA value, we are getting 15.54. Similarly, HD is equal to MCD is an anti-clockwise moment, that is minus 51.11. MDC is equal to 0. MDC is equal to 0 divided by L is equal to 3. You will get HD bar is minus -17.30. Okay, so if you do sigma fx is equal to 0, sigma fx is equal to 0 ante em student, so let us suppose this reaction will acting in this direction, HA is acting, HD is acting in this direction, HA plus HD is equal to S. This is the formula, HA plus HD is equal to S. So if you do this one, HA value is 15.54, HD value is -17.30. If you do this one, S value is minus, HD value is -1.76. Okay, that means HD will act opposite direction, HD value, HD will act opposite direction, S value, S is acting in this direction, S is acting opposite to HD. Okay, like that S value will going to calculate -1.76. So now for the solving this problem, there up to this sway analysis non-sway analysis completed. In non-sway analysis, we are calculated final end moments. After that, we are calculated the reactions and all those things. So here, sway force we are calculated. Sway force is -1.76. So sway forces we are calculated. So now what we need to do is, we need to apply a sway force S on this frame by removing all the loads. Only I am applying sway force here. I am removed all the loads and applied the sway force. By applying sway force, so we need to find out the final end moment. So these are the sway moments. Sway moments we need to calculate. So for the calculation of sway moments, so we need to calculate first fixed moments. For the calculation of fixed moments, we have a formula. If the support, that means if with respect to left support, right side set settle and then go. Fixed moment formula is 6EI delta by L square. Here delta is not there, M is also not there. So here two unknowns is there. So for analyzing one equation with the two unknowns, it is not possible. So that's why what I am doing is I am taking a ratio of moments between members AB and CD. I'm taking ratio of moments between MFCD ratio is kuntunnanu. So from that, the ratio of moments we're going to get. From that ratio of moments, we're going to get here MF. Let us suppose a fixed moment for the member 1 is MF1. I'm taking fixed moment for the member, this vertical member CD is, I'm taking MF2. This fixed moment for the member AB is MF1. Fixed moment for the member vertical member CD is, I'm taking MF2. If you take MF1, that is fixed moment for the member AB. That means this is a left support, this is a right support. So because of the application of force, right support is sinking. That means sway force is there. In this direction, sway is possible. Sway is possible in this direction. So if you write fixed end moment formula is 6EI delta by L square. For the member, vertical member AB, the formula is 6EI delta by L square. Here, E value is I value 2i, I value is 2i. Delta value we don't know, L value I am substituted, L square. So fixed moment for the CB members, 6EI delta by L square. L value for this member is only 3. I am taking ratio of 6EI delta by L square to 6EI by delta by L square. I am getting this ratio is 1/2. Okay, I got this ratio. That means moment carried by, moment developed for the member MF1 and MF2 ratio is, MF1 to MF2 ratio is 1/2. So by taking this concept, by taking this ratio, I am assuming arbitrary moment for the member, this member and this member, arbitrary moment for this this member and this particular member AB and CD. So let us take MF1, that means moment developed or moment, fixed moment for the AB, particular member AB, I am assuming -50, but because it will produce anti-clockwise moment. Because of right support is right side support is sinking with respect to left side support. So that's why fixed moments developed are the anti-clockwise moments. So anti-clockwise moments considers a negative value. So that's why MF1 I'm considering -50 kN/m. Okay. So automatically MF2 will become -100 kN/m. Why? Because MF1 by MF2 ratio is 1/2. The ratio is 1/2. If you do MF1 is -50, MF2 is 100. -50 by 100 is automatically 1/2. So that proportion we are using, I'm using arbitrary moment, minus 50 kilonewton meter. Otherwise you take 100 also, MF1, if you take MF1 is equal to 100, you'll get MF2 is equal to minus 200. If you take MF1 is equal to minus 25, automatically MF2 is equal to minus 50. If you take MF1 is equal to minus 1, MF2 is equal to minus 2. Okay, so take any value we can take. Okay, we are assumed some value for MF1 and MF2, so that sway force will different. Okay, now here developed sway force will going to change. Okay, so that's why we need to calculate what the sway force developed here, that we need to calculate for the arbitrary moments applied here. Okay, MF1, MFAB plus MFBC, MFAB plus MFBA is equal to minus 50 kilonewton, that is fixed end moments for the member AB. Fixed end moment for the member CD is MFCD and MFDC is equal to minus 100 kilonewton meter. Okay, so now by taking these fixed end moments, we need to calculate final end moments. So distribution factors is same, that we are calculated this frame. First we are calculated the frame. So same values, whatever the values. Distribution factor does not depend upon the load. It just depends upon sectional configuration of the frame. So that's why frame is not changed, only the moments is changed. So distribution, whatever the distribution factors we are used for the non-sway analysis, we are using the same distribution factors here. So after that, I am written fixed end moments for the AB and BA, CD and DC. After this one, we have to do, analysis by using moment distribution method. Okay, so for this, D is a hinged support. You see, D support is a hinged support. That means we need to release the moment from D support. We need to release the moment from support D. So because D is a hinged support, it will not take any moment. So that's why what I am doing is, I am adding plus positive 100 kilonewton meter for the joint D. Why? Because it's a hinged support, it will not take in. We need to release it. If you release this one, automatically half of the moment need to carry to near support. Half of the moment need to carry to the near joint of support. Here the 100 law of 50 plus 50. So now unbalanced moment is there for this C member. Unbalanced moment of 50 is there, minus 100 plus 50. Minus 100 plus 50 and minus 50 is there. Unbalanced moment at joint C is there, minus 50. Okay, minus 100 is there, 50 is there, here it is 0 is there. Okay, minus 100 plus 50, minus 0. And you will get minus 50 unbalanced moment is there at the joint C. Unbalanced moment at joint C is minus 50 is there. Okay, so minus 50 we have to distribute to member CB and member CD. So here minus 50 into 0.571, you will get minus 28.255, minus 28.55, but we have to add opposite sign, plus 28.55 we need to add for the member CB. Minus 50 into 0.429, you will get minus 21.45, but we need to add opposite sign value, that is 21.45 we need to add to member CD. Okay, similarly, if you take this joint B, here unbalanced moment of minus 50 is there. There is 0 is there, minus 50 is there. Unbalanced moment is minus 50 is there. Okay, so we need to distribute this unbalanced moment of minus 50 to the member BA and BC. Member BA and BC we need to distribute. Okay. Minus 50 into 0.5 is the manaku entha 25 is the minus 25 is the opposite sign then manu add chesukovali BA ki. Minus 50 into 0.5 is the minus 25 is the opposite sign then manu add chesukunamandi. Now half of the moment we need to carry to the near channel. Half of the moment we need to carry to the near channel. So like that, we need to calculate unbalanced moment and we need to transfer to the this we need to distribute the load to the members. After that, we have to carry the moments to the near joints. Like that, this processor will continue until at the joint equilibrium equation must be satisfied. We need to do the same processor. If you take joint B, Yeah, joint B, joint equilibrium equation is satisfying. That means minus 30.74 plus 30.74. That means moment at B is equal to zero. That means it is a satisfying joint equilibrium equation. Here is also satisfying joint equilibrium equation. All these values are came. If you sum all these values, you're going to get this value. If you sum all these values, you're going to get this value. If you sum all these values, you're going to get this. So just summing all these values, you'll go into this final moments. So these are the sway moments. So these are the sway moments. By taking these moments, again we need to calculate the reactions. Again, we need to calculate the reactions here. If you take this support, this is HA dash. Let us suppose HA dash, this one, HD dash, this one, this is S dash. Okay. So same. Sigma fx is equal to 0, s dash plus ha, ha bar plus hd dot is equal to 0. Ha is equal to, for the calculation of ha, this is the formula, mvab plus mba by l1, this is the formula. Simply, if you use this formula, otherwise you take, if you draw free body diagram of ab member, and you take moment about b is equal to 0, and you will get the ha value. Otherwise, use this formula, mab plus mba by l1. For the get a d, hd, mcd plus mdc, by L2. Okay. You have to use the same signs. You have to use same signs. Clockwise into clockwise, clockwise into positive, anti-clockwise into negative, like that. You have to use the same signs for the MAB and MBA, MCD and MDC. So you're going to get H dash is 20.083. So actually, actual sway force is only minus, actual sway force we are calculated, that is only minus 1.76, but yes, we got the sway force. We got the sway force as 20.083. We got the sway force as 20.083. So there is an error is there. For this error, we need to correct this error. Actual sway force is minus 1.76, but we are calculated. We got sway force is 20.083. For this, what we need to do is we have to go for sway correction factor. So we need to calculate sway correction factor. So sway correction factor K is equal to S by S dash. Here S value is actual sway force minus 1.76. S dash is the sway force. That is sway force calculated by applying arbitrary moment. S dash is equal to 20.083. If you calculate sway correction factor for this problem, we are getting minus 0.0876. So this is the sway correction factor we got. So for the calculation of final moments, we need to use this formula. We need to use this formula. Once again, I'll show you here. So final moments, including sway moments and non-sway moments. Formula is there. So final moments is equal to non-sway moments. Final moments is equal to, so this formula you need to use. Final moments is equal to non-sway moments plus K into sway moments. So non-sway moments we are calculated here. So these are the sway moments. Okay. For the, if you calculate final moment at A is equal to, non-sway moment is 31.00 plus K into minus 40.44. If you solve this one, you'll get 34.54. Final moment at A is equal to 34.454. We'll get, similarly, you calculate final moment at joint B, also you'll get. So if you observe, if you cross check this one, if you solve this final moment at joint B and joint C, same moments, joint equilibrium equation has to be satisfied. That means at joint B, 59.65 has to come. It is 59.65 minus 59.65 raval. And kind of be zero raval. And moment at B has to be zero. Moment of C has to zero. Is zero raval and remain a chop yesamardam. Okay? At check yes quality. Zero chin and condi, whatever the problem we are did, that is correct. Otherwise, somewhere we are did mistake. Okay. So with the like that, we'll going to calculate final moments. Okay. So this is the procedure for the calculation of final moments of a sway frame by using moment distribution method. Is it clear? Ask some doubts related to this problem.
Sir,
yeah, you tell me. 69.
Sir, last low final moment calculations low actual sway values ella che ardham avatlu
actual sway value etlo chin ardham kaledu amma s value sir. S value you want s value na actual sway is yes. Nothing but s
yes sir
so yeah okay what is your name
Manisha sir
yeah Manisha rule number
69 sir
okay well very good question I'll appreciate you okay so actually this is a sway force so if you see this loading you can observe this is a sway frame that means sway is possible what is meant to say AB member will move from its original position to another position I'll show here I'll draw one diagram so that you can understand easily let's suppose this is frame so this is a this is frame so because of this application of horizontal force because of the application of horizontal force the frame that means vertical member will try to yeah let us suppose it is moving like this so ee end anedi ikkadku vastundi this is delta is sway is a delta okay so this is delta sway is takes place this is let us suppose this is delta so let us suppose I'm deflection delta anukuntunna d antunna okay because of this deflection a fixed moments will going to develop okay so this is this way what I am doing is to arrest this way I am providing a support here so whatever the application of load here we are applying some load here because of the application of load whatever the applied load is there that will take by this support so this frame become non-sway frame this way become non-sway frame here one reaction will going to develop here here will reaction will going to develop this is called a sway force yes whatever the reaction will going to develop here that is a sway force yes so how to calculate this sway force here we have moments we are calculated as sway moments non sway moments here we are calculated mab we are calculated this is mab and we are calculated we are calculated mab that is clockwise moment also we are calculated mbc mba that is also clockwise moment okay so let us suppose this is member support a and support b support a is a fixed support so because of this application of load the reaction will going to develop here so that is ha okay so because of the application of load at support d a reaction will going to develop okay So for the calculation of sway force, yes. For the calculation of sway force, yes. The easy option is sigma fx is equal to zero. Sigma fx is equal to zero. So sigma fx is equal to zero ankonam manaku horizontal force em ostundi chudandi. So if it is one force is there here, then this force p, force unte manaku problem lo force ledandi, force p plus ha plus hd minus s is equal to zero. So this is the equation. Indulo p force manaku applied lo 20 or 30 ostundi, ha value teliyadu, hd value teliyadu. For that what we need to, we have to calculate ha value and hd value. HD value క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేయాలండి. సో హెచ్ఏ వాల్యూ క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేయాలంటే ఏంటంటే, వీ కెన్ టేక్ ఫర్ ది క్యాలిక్యులేషన్ ఆఫ్ హెచ్ఏ, జస్ట్ సింప్లీ యూ టేక్ మూమెంట్ అబౌట్ బి ఫర్ దిస్ మెంబర్, మూమెంట్ అబౌట్ బి ఫర్ దిస్ వర్టికల్ మెంబర్ ఏబి, మూమెంట్ అబౌట్ బి తీసుకున్నారనుకోండి, యూ విల్ గెట్ హెచ్ఏ వాల్యూ. ఎందుకంటే ఇక్కడ మనకు ఫ్రీ బాడీ డయాగ్రామ్ లో ఎంఏబి పాజిటివ్ ఉంది, ఎంబిఏ పాజిటివ్ ఉంది, హెచ్ఏ ఉంది, length is L. Should just simply you take a moment about B, automatically you will get HA. Otherwise use this formula, MAB plus MBA by L to getting H value, sway force, MAB plus MBA by L, MAB plus MBA by L, like that we need to calculate. So HA value is 15.54 వచ్చిందండి. సో దిస్ ఇస్ HA. అగైన్ యూ క్యాలిక్యులేట్ హెచ్డి, హెచ్డి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు సేమ్ ఎంబి ఎంసిడి ప్లస్ ఎండిసి బై ఎల్ ఎల్ టూ, దిస్ ఇస్ ఎల్ టూ, ఎంబిసి ప్లస్ ఎండిసి బై ఎల్ టూ, యూఆర్ గెటింగ్ మైనస్ 17.3330. సో సిగ్మా ఎఫెక్స్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ జీరో వేస్తే హెచ్ఏ ప్లస్ హెచ్డి మైనస్ ఎస్, యూఆర్ లెట్ అస్ అస్యూమ్ వీఆర్ దిస్ ఇస్ ఆర్ యాక్టింగ్ ఇన్ దిస్ డైరెక్షన్. సో ఆపోజిట్ డైరెక్షన్ లో స్వే ఫోర్స్ ఉంటుందండి. సో స్వే రియాక్షన్ ఫోర్స్, దిస్ ఇస్ స్వే రియాక్షన్ ఫోర్స్ ఆపోజిట్ టు దిస్ దిస్ ఫోర్సెస్. సో ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ వేర్ క్యాలిక్యులేటెడ్ మైనస్ 1.76 యాజ్ స్వే ఫోర్స్. అర్థమైంది అమ్మ ఏమన్నా? స్వే ఫోర్స్ క్యాలిక్యులేషన్ చేసాం ఇట్లా. చెప్పండి చెప్పండి, ఇంకా డౌట్స్ ఉన్నాయా?
అంటే సార్, ఇక్కడ ఒక వాల్యూ క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేసినాం మైనస్ 1.76 అని.
ఓకే, వెరీ గుడ్.
అక్కడ వాల్యూస్ 3.54 అలా వేసుకున్నాం కదా సార్, అందుకని అర్థం కాలేదు.
వాల్యూస్ అవి 3. ఇవి వదిలేయండి, అవి వదిలేయండి.
ఓకే సార్,
అది వదిలేయండి, అది యాక్చువల్ గా ప్రాబ్లమ్ లో వేరే చేస్తారు. జస్ట్ యూజ్ దిస్ ఫార్ములా ఫర్ ది క్యాలిక్యులేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఫైనల్ మూమెంట్. ఫైనల్ మూమెంట్స్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు నాన్ స్వే మూమెంట్స్ ప్లస్ కే ఇంటు స్వే మూమెంట్స్. యూజ్ దిస్ ఫార్ములా, దట్స్ ఇట్.
ఓకే సార్, థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్.
అర్థమైంది అమ్మాయి, మొత్తం ప్రాబ్లం మొత్తం అర్థమైంది కదా? చూడండి ఒకసారి ఈ వీడియో కూడా, నేను మన కోర్స్ యూట్యూబ్ లో పోస్ట్ చేస్తాను ప్రతి వీడియో కూడా, సింపుల్ ఈ మోడల్లో ఒక వీడియోని పోస్ట్ చేస్తున్నా, గో త్రూ దట్ వీడియో, దట్ మేబీ దిస్ ప్రాబ్లం స్టిల్. యూ హ్యావ్ ఎనీ డౌట్స్? ఎనీ వన్ యూ కెన్ రెస్పాండ్.